Hey guys, just doing a follow-up and repair of the JVC RX 5540
with a 554V.
Yeah, 554V. Anyway, I pretty much went over the wiring and all the plugs and everything. They're all good. It's basically whenever you tap it a certain way or move it a certain way, it goes into overload. So there's definitely a bad solder joint. But unfortunately, as you can see, there's no service port on the bottom, so that means we have to fish all this out, and it's not going to be easy. I'll have to cut that. Nothing is unpluggable from the board. Like this transformer's soldered right to the board. There's no plug to unplug it, so that has to be unraveled there. I'll probably have to fold it over. This has to be removed. This. It's going to take a while. So what I'll do is I'll put the camera on my headset and we'll just listen to some tunes and slowly pull it apart and take you along with me, and then we'll try and find the solder joint. Well, you can see I won't be talking in this. I'm going to be listening to my music. If you're wondering what this is the preamp. You can also check the solder. Jesus, even the plug soldered, even the cord is soldered right to the board. There's no plugs on this one. It's not really serviceable. The paste is a little dry. Probably wouldn't hurt to redo it. Clean them up and redo them. Would be nice just to take the heat sink out. I can do that. I don't even have to unmount those. Could have just left that. Screwdriver. Top there for everything else. We've got little plastic grommets in here as well. Yep. What a pain in the ass. Made this thing. Somewhere. Screws would have sufficed. Seriously. never easy. Part two, just to get this repaired. So hoping I could just lift the board out, but it's not going to be that easy. I'm going to have to disassemble the whole bloody thing. Going to do. We just have to really go over it when we got it apart so we don't have to do this again. Just bend this out of the way. Oh, that I did not just crack the board there. I'll have to patch it up. Might be turning this into a block amp after all. Oh, come on. Not one thing in this thing has got a plug on it. This is like, doesn't even make it hardly worth it. I had to take the front off. Wow. This cable right here, no plug on it. Now I'm starting to see why no one wanted to repair this. Okay. I cracked the board, so depending on how it's cracked, if it's really bad, then I am going to make a block amp out of it. Yeah, I'm not going to sit there and re-solder every trace that I broke. It's probably, it might be in an area that doesn't have any traces, which we're about to find out. Just to put you on my part, I shouldn't have done that. Yeah, all that just to get that out. Yes. Let's put that aside for a minute. A bit of dirt under there I didn't get at. Let's put this back. Take that screw up before we break it even further. So we got a half inch crack there in the board now. I'd be surprised if it's not damaged beyond repair now. But I'm not going to edit it out. I will post my stupidity. What are the chances? One trace is probably damaged. I can live with that. Whew, we lucked out. I'll put that aside. That'll have to be repaired. Oh. Maybe I can show you. There's the split right there. I don't know if you can see that or not. It's right before it hits the first trace on the board there. It's nothing. Easy fix. Stupid, but it's gotta be done. Anyway. Ooh, look at the damage around there. Okay, these aren't too bad. Ooh, there's a couple of dry solder joints on the one regulator there. The other solder looks pretty good. So we're going to reflow the regulators. I'm pretty sure that's probably what it is. And we'll touch these up, but I don't really see anything majorly wrong with them. Except for that one there. Let's see one. I'm going to mark it so I don't forget. So that's bad. This one here's gotta go. And this one here. And those are probably the tissues right there. Not too sure how much you guys are going to see this, but continue anyway. Definitely cracked solder on that one. Good. All that just to drop a little bit of solder on it. It'll take longer to fix the damage I did to it. Okay, that's done. Take a quick look at the board that I destroyed. It doesn't even look like that place is even bad, but we're going to scratch the layer away anyway just to see. Okay.
broken in two places. It's not bad. You got it.
We'll try it, see what happens. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll cut it here and let me get this thing back together and see if she fires up. Okay, I just wanted to quickly test it. I didn't want to totally throw it together just in case there is a bad problem. But there is a problem with that board, thanks to me. But I think it's all right. Put the preamp back in. I looked it over. It looks fine. I mean, down the road, these will have to be removed and new paste will have to be put on them. They're all drying up. Okay, the solder joints are good on the bottom, so I'll probably have to service it for a while. The bad area was around the regulators. Now let me turn it on. It works, and you don't get a error. Well, it's saying overload. I just clicked and say overload. It doesn't even do that anymore. And the inputs and everything, I've checked them, they're all good. So, like I said, it was just that one trace that was bad from me cracking the board. But what I did when I put the board back in is I put a piece of electrical tape to as a gasket between the board and the, obviously, the ground. So when I put the board back in, if that trace was touching the tab, it wouldn't ground out to the chassis, which it didn't. So, well, obviously, because I got tape across it. But that's it. I'm just going to shoot the back back on. And we're good to go. I hope you enjoyed that not so into detail repair. I mean, that's basically normally what it is. It's either a solder joint or it's a bad transistor or FET or module or, you know what I mean? Later, guys.